Hey, happy Sunday. I'm Chelsea from thestudentarchitect.com, and today I'm going to show you how to jog your elevations in Revit. Now, before we get into it, if at any point along the way you find that you like this video, don't forget to hit that thumbs up. And if you haven't already, don't forget to subscribe and make sure you turn on the bell so that you don't miss out when I post new videos. And if you're interested in any of my paid or free courses, you can go check them out over at thestudentarchitect.com/classes, and you can see which classes are now open for enrollment. All right, let's get into it. So let's say you have a project and you're trying to show an elevation, but part of a building or something else is blocking your view from where you want to cut the elevation from. So I have a past video showing you how you can jog your section cut, so I recommend checking that out if you want to see how to do that as well, but you can actually do that with elevations too. So right here I have an elevation, and it's a little bit less intuitive when you're working with elevation cuts rather than section cuts, because the section cut, you can see exactly where that line is. For the elevation, it's actually hidden until you click on a certain element of that elevation symbol. So if I click on the box here, let's zoom in a little bit. If I click on the box here, you can see that we have the option to add other views to this elevation symbol. But if I click on one of those arrows that's pointing towards a view, it will then show you where that section cut is or where that elevation cut is. So if I zoom out, you can see the extent of the view, the width of the view, and you can also see the extents that are indicated by that dashed line. So when you're clicked onto this line, you can see up in the ribbon, there are a couple of options here where you can change the size crop, which we're not going to get into, but you also see an icon for split segment. So if I click on split segment and hover over this line, you'll see that it's going to slice that line wherever I want it to go. So let's say I want to see the front of this building, but I also want to cut down. I don't want this portion of the building to interfere with the elevation, so I want to cut beyond that. So I'm just going to snip the line here, and you can see, depending on which side of the line I hover over, it'll either bring this portion forward or backward, or it will bring this portion forward or backward. So this is the portion that we want to stick with, so I'm just going to slide it up past this portion of the building here, and I'm just going to click my mouse to place that segment. And now that we've made that slice, you can see we have these shape handle arrows here. Let me double escape. Oops, let's go back into it. And you can see now that we've placed in a snip, we can actually change where these jogs happen. So you're not locked into anything once you snip that line. So I can drag that one closer to the exterior of the building. I can drag this one up closer to this elevation or back more if I wanted to. And I could do the same with this side as well. So now if I go to this elevation, I'll just double click on the arrow there. You can see that there's nothing obstructing that view. Whereas if I control Z a couple of times, you can see now it's getting cut off from that bump out in the building. But if I control Y to go back to where we were, you can see it's now unobstructed. Now, if I ever change my mind and I want to bring it back to where it was, let's go back to that view. Let's close out these other views here. Let's go back to that view. Again, just going to click on this arrow here where it has the four, and that will bring up where that elevation cut is. And all I need to do is just slide it back in line with the original cut, or I could have slid this one back to align with the other segments, and it will just mend itself back together. So I really hope that you found this video helpful, and if you did, please hit that like button, and if you haven't subscribed yet, go ahead and subscribe, and make sure you turn on the bell so that you get notified when I post new videos. If you're interested in a more structured way of learning Revit, go ahead and check out my Foundations of Revit course over at thestudentarchitect.com/classes, and there you'll find all kinds of information about how the course is structured, what I'll be teaching, and all kinds of things like that. I hope you have a great day, and I'll see you next Sunday.